Flames stretch as far south as Bonita Beach Road, all the way north to Corkscrew Road. NBC2 has team coverage tonight as multiple crews are there on scene, as well as First Alert meteorologist Justin Hobbs here with me in studio. Let's start with my co-anchor Trent Bennett. He is field anchoring tonight at mile marker 116, which is Bonita Beach Road. He's been speaking with neighbors for the past couple of hours who are evacuating to safety. Trent, what's the latest tonight out there?
Hey, Claire, good evening. A lot of sheer panic is the best way I would put it, just from a human perspective. But let's show you what we're dealing with at the moment. As you said, big firefight. This is about the best vantage point you're going to get, and I'll explain to you why. We are about a half a mile from Bonita Beach Road. This is the mile marker 116 exit, so this is the very last overpass. And we want to leave this up long enough, this shot for you long enough, because what we're watching are two different agencies. I've been able to calculate that one of them is Lee County Sheriff's Office. Haven't been able to get close enough to see who the other helicopter is owned by, but we're watching them. Here's one right here. This is the Lee County Sheriff's Office, and they are picking up these helibuckets. I was told by a deputy just moments ago that these carry about 500 to 700 gallons of water, and they are picking up these buckets, and we have watched this firefight start from the north side of where we're reporting to you from the overpass. And now you're watching it just about, I would probably say 100 or so feet from Bonita Beach Road. And this is the problem we're dealing with, Claire. There it is right there. That's them dropping the water there at the moment. The problem is I've been told there's about 30 or 40 residential roads from where I'm reporting to you right now on East Terry Street that takes you to Bonita Beach Road. So a lot of families here at the moment. And we actually spoke to the man moments ago who they're using one of his ponds to pick this water up and drop it off. He couldn't get to his house. They wouldn't let him through, but they're using, you're watching the helicopter here. They're going over here to this pond on his road, which is just a couple of miles from where we're standing, and they're picking up water and then they're carrying it over to where this fight. And again, the wind is blowing pretty heavily. So we're watching this firefight move. And every single time we've watched a new black plume of smoke develop, that's indicating that this fire is in fact moving. But I do want to move and show you, Harrison, can you go ahead and show to the left of where you're standing just right here? Claire, these are people that live over here. And these are people who have either gotten out of their vehicle, walked over here, or they've taken their bike. I've watched people take their four-wheeler out of their truck and drive it over here because they're trying to see the condition of their home. And then Harrison, if you'll go ahead and pan the camera over here, look at this right here. There's people right here, be careful, buddy. There's people right here that are just waiting to get through. They don't know what their home's like. We've talked to several of them, and we'll share their stories with you later on in our later newscast. But a lot of these people, a lot of this is agriculture. A lot of these people own a lot of property. A lot of these homes are not necessarily close together. So they own goats, they own pigs, they own horses, and they're trying to see if their animals are okay. And then, of course, just moments ago, we spoke to a man, and I want you guys to play the sound that we spoke to just a minute ago. We'll play his interview in just a second. But he was trying to get through. His wife called him. We were watching him on the phone with his wife, and he begged the Lee County Sheriff's Office deputy that was standing on this overpass to let him through. Let's go ahead and play that. We spoke to him just a minute ago. He's just trying to get home, and this is what he had to say to us.
I told him I'm coming through no matter what. I got my three dogs in there. He can do whatever he wants. That's my house. You can't tell me. I can't go to my house.
I hope you could hear that. Basically, what he was saying is he's just trying to get home. He doesn't care what they say. He's got to get to his wife. He said they've got dogs, they've got cats, their kids. Luckily, they were able to take their children to their babysitter. So that's what these folks are dealing with right now, and that's what we're watching play out. But two agencies right now, they're taking water, they're dumping water, and the good news is that they've been able to open up the right lane that takes you north on I-75. Our Madison Adams, she's going to give you a road level view in just a moment. But Claire, stay with us. Bring us back up in just a couple of minutes, and we'll kind of give you a condition of how this firefight's going. Claire, back to you.